Hi guys, we are glad to introduce our block storage service based on Ceph and OpenStack. We had spent 2 years to build the service. We have many experience to share with you. My name is Yong Ze, he is Hao Mai. The contents have four parts. Firstly, I will introduce our block storage service future and minion deployment architecture. I also will share how to integrate OpenStack and Ceph. Secondly, Hao Mai will introduce how to make high performance. We optimize all IO stack. Certainly, I will introduce how to set a Ceph crash map for high durability. We had run many Ceph class in the past year, so in the last, I will share our experience on Ceph operation. First part, block storage service. The slide shows our block storage service features. We have a high performance and stronger durability. We provide real-time snapshot and two value types. How to build a block storage service. The table lists all the software used in the block storage service. We will update software version to get the new feature and the high performance. Next, I will show our minion deployment architecture. The minion deployment have 12 OSD nodes and three more monitor nodes. The node have two 10 GB network. The one is used for storage network. The other is used for VM network. Our deployment architecture is very easy to scale out. You can add 12 OSD nodes for expand Ceph capacity. You also can scale to many nodes. Then we focus on OpenStack, how to integrate the Ceph and OpenStack. The native OpenStack have two disadvantages. The slow instance create action and the both store, because no one can build near to download the whole image by HTTP. How to optimize it? The method is using the Ceph pool. If we create a new instance, the Nova computer will not download the whole image by HTTP. The instance can directly read the image data from Ceph by TCP. The instance only needs to read a few data to boot, so it is very fast. We can see QoS is very, very important for cloud multi-tenants. So we backpoint the QML slot into the 1.2 version. We use a single multi backend to provide two value times. The performance value resides in the Ceph SSD pool. The capacity value resides in the SATA pool. We also use the single multi attacher to provide shared value.
Okay. Before we have an overview of our block storage servers, so next we will focus on how to achieve high performance block storage servers. And before we have dive into Ceph, how to improve Ceph most, we need to back to OS lawyer. Because Ceph is a distributed storage servers, and it related to many other things like OS, network, or HDD or SSD hardware. So before we delve into it, we need to have an overview of, about OS configuration. Okay, Let's see. The first part is CPU, and as we know, now more and more CPU module try to save power for some money reason, and so it will lower the power save model, so to save more power for server. So if we want to get more performance from CPU, we need to equal performance to OS CPU power save mode. And then we introduce C group for it. We have the combine the story node and the computer node to one box. So if we want to make a full use of CPU, we need to bind the CPU OSD process to fix the cost. In our production environment, we bound one or two cores per OSD. The second part is memory. If you want to support NVMe for your system, I stress you just turn off it because Ceph can't make full use of it and may have some performance degraded. So the next is set VM swappness to zero. I think you can know that if page in and page out process it happen, Ceph will very poor for it. And the next two parts is bulk and file system. I think each SSD application need aware of it. We need to equal deadline to block device schedule and mount no time and no barrier with the file system. What's the mean of no time and no barrier? I think because Ceph your local file system with object, so file system always record access time as file metadata. So because Ceph don't make use of it and it's really harmful to performance, so we need to disable it. And no barrier is a deliverable feature for file. And so we have Django in Ceph, so we can disable it. Next, we will introduce our QMU backport and new some enhanced features. So mainly is introduced some features like smooth I/O limit and discard and flush request enhance and L-bust and multi-queue support. Multi-queue support is mainly used by QMU, so we can get higher performance and IOPS for QMU and VM. So next, we will dive into Ceph IO stack. We can see the bottle picture. I want to have an overview of how IBD image is used by VM. So each IBD image will constants of many objects. And object is a Ceph Redos concept. And Redos will store object as a file to a local file system. So you can regard as IBD image will consist of many files in distributed files. So if we want to improve IBD image performance, we need to improve local file system or how to make use how Ceph OSD make use of it. And let's see the top picture. Top picture is the one IO request how to from QMU thread and to Ceph OSD and then store it to local file system. And it may be not clearly, but the picture I want to show is that the thread is where one IO request need to flow many threads if it want to store at local file system. So for example, network thread will receive the IO request and it will dispatch it to OSD thread and then dispatch again. So one IO thread will flow into many threads. So in order to improve the performance of Ceph, we need to reduce the overhead of context switch behind the IO request dispatch. So next, we will have 7 points to avoid it or reduce it. So at first, we need to introduce the first point is the keeper FD. FD is an OS concept for local file system. Ceph OSD will get a file descriptor to handle the IO and to write or read file data from local file system. So why we need to increase FD? Because system calls such as open and close FD is very consuming much time for a normal IO. So you can imagine if we have many data objects and we need to open many files. So we need to close some and open some and it always repeatedly happened. So we need to avoid it in SSD, for SSD cluster, Ceph cluster. So as it should, we need to increase FD cache and OMAP handle cache to a very large size to hold all objects. And the below configuration is showed file store OMAP handle cache size and the file store FD cache size is used to control it. And besides this, we need to change the obvious default object size. Because if we have a large SSD and not showed as slides, and we need to hold more objects, so we need to increase the object size. So by default, we can increase object size to 16 million bytes, and we can use IBD check size in OpenStack Cinder to create a different object size volume. Okay, the point two is the spice read and write. Okay, as I mentioned above, one object is a file in local file system. So if user application in a VM want to write a range of data to a volume, and the object will owe a few kilobytes of data. So in general, though, we one object may only exist a few kilobytes data. So it is really helpful for SD and capacity. So, but if we create a snapshot or OSD recovery happened, so it will copy four object and then save it another place. So if it happened, it is really harmful to normal IO pace. So maybe if you use Ceph, and you may get a very bad performance if you create a snapshot for volume and then write data to it, and you will see the very, very harmful performance from the VM. So, but why we not enable the configuration you see file store FEMAP? Because it's we have an existing bug for kernel XFS, and we Ceph in order to avoid the data corruption, so we just disable it. So if you have ensure your kernel XF is fix this bug, or you have other ways to fix it, so you can enable it. You can get much performance improvements from this if your credit central or OSD recover happened. So the point three is drop default limits. As we know, Ceph is mainly designed to HDD disk. So HDD is much slower than SSD. So many configuration view need to change. For example, file store WB sorter and file store queen and journal queen and more related configures. Related to recover and scrap, we can improve it 10 times compared to original view. So, okay, the fourth point is use IBD cache. I think many of you and know it, and it will have remarkable performance improvement for sequence read and write. You can just do it, and I think it's pretty good. And the final point is cache. We know catch is plays a very important role for a normal storage system. So how to make use of it? As I mentioned about Ceph, by default, Ceph uses a very small cache size, and it is designed to HDD disk. So if you want to use SSD, so you want to enable much bigger cache. So in order to use it, you need to increase cache size. But the default cache container or implementation is not suitable for large cache size. It is not very effective. So we need to change the default cache container to random cache. It is another cache in Ceph source, but we need to do some code. So next, we will introduce implement new effective cache, replacing rhythm cache. And the sixth point is keep a thread running. As I mentioned above, I/O need to flow many threads. And if network thread receive I/O request, it needs to wake up the next thread. And the next thread needs to wake next thread. So if we so thread often wake up and sleep, wake up and sleep. So many CPU time is consumed in it. So if we want to reduce the overhead of thread sleep and wake up, we need to reduce the time consumed by sleep and wake up. So we just have a patch for it. You can set OSDOP worker wake time for it. And this time can be controlled to control how many times the thread needs to wake. So we can have a very better performance result from this patch if you use SSD backend. So the final point is async message. It's an experiment feature, and we still did some coding for it. But I think if you want to building your or Ceph or SSD cluster and want to deploy it in a future, maybe a few months, you can focus on it, and it can get much better latency for the knob I/O. Why it can improve performance? Because the origin Ceph network layer will use two threads for each client. With the client increases, especially for cloud environment, we have many VM will access OSD. So we will have many threads will be created in OSD side. So if we increase the thread in OSD side, the connect switch consume time is very, very high. So in order to reduce it, we need to introduce the kernel event notification method. For example, Linux is epoch interface, and BSD system is keyq interface. So next, we will see the IOPS result for it. It's a very simple test, and based on self dumping, we have prepared Firefly release, but it is not a test. So we just show the dumping release based on one OSD and one client, and LDAP is 16. So of course, the replicated size is 1. So you can simply compute the picture. Left picture is the origin dumping release. It is nearly 1,600 IOPS. And right is our patched performance. You can achieve 10,000 IOPS, and the SSD is Intel SSD. So the hardware IOPS is nearly 20,000 or 30,000. So because of Ceph double write and some metadata consumer, we can make one OSD can make a full use of SSD for our Ceph cluster. And for the master branch, Ceph, we can get, I remember it is 3 or 4,000 IOPS. So it is still a big gap between our performance SSD special branch. So as for latency, you can see the lines, and we can get one microsecond millisecond for 4K rhythm write, and for one TB RBD image, and 500 microseconds for read OP. Compared to master branch, we have much improvement and very outstanding large data set performance. Okay.
In the part, I will introduce how to make the high durability in the Ceph. You need some knowledge about the Ceph. There are many documents about the Ceph reliability model, and after we read the document, we can derive the reliability formula. In order to save our time, I will not explain the detail of the Ceph reliability model and the durability formula. I put them in the last of our slides. when need to optimize, as you know, in the distributed system, the data placement decides durability. In the Ceph, the crash map decides data placement. So crash map decides durability. The default crash map setting is not good for us. We need a new crash map setting to get a higher durability. what need to optimize? Two conclusions from the Ceph reliability model. Durability depends on the OSD recovery time. Durability depends on the number of copy set in the Ceph pool. What is the copy set? The principle of a PG's OSD set is a copy set. The data loss in the Ceph is the loss of any PG. Actually, it's a loss of any copy set if the replication number is 3 and we lost 3 OSDs in Ceph. The probability of data loss depends on the number of copy set, because the 3 OSDs maybe know the copy set. So we know the shorter recovering time, the higher durability. The less the number of copy set, the higher durability. How to optimize it? Because the crash map setting decides the recovering time, and the crash map setting decides the number of copy set, so we need to change the crash map setting to get a higher durability. Firstly, let's to compute the durability in the default crash map setting. In the case, we have 3 ranks. And so each rank have 24 OSDs. If the replication number is 3, the number of copy set is 24 multiplied 24. The result is so big. You can use the common Ceph OSD tree to see the crash map. It's the default crash setting. In the case the replication number is 3, the durability 9 is A. The durability is better than read 5, and the read 1 yellow is equal. Read 6. But it's not good enough for us because the cloud is a larger scale. We need higher durability. So let's reduce the recovering time. In the default class map setting, the host bucket have three OSDs. If one OSD out, only two OSDs they can do the data recovering. So the recovering time is too long. We need at more the OSD to do the data recovering to reduce the recovering time. But we cannot add more OSD in the host bucket. Why? Because the host have a network bandwidth limit and disk slot limit. So we need to edit the new bucket instead of a host bucket to contain the OSD. The new bucket's name is OSD domain. It's a logical bucket, unlike the host and rank. We can edit more the OSD in the OSD domains. So the recovery time is very short. You can see the green white frame is the OSD domain bucket. Dashed line indicates that it's a logical bucket. We added the new bucket, but we have no change the number of copy set. In the Ceph OSD tree, there are some differences. We use OSD domain bucket instead of host bucket. So each OSD domain have 12 OSDs. In the new crash map, we reduce the recovering time. The durability 9 is 9. Compared with the default crash map setting, we improve durability 10 times. Next, how to reduce the number of copy set? The method is adding the replica domain bucket. Why? In the picture, the blue white frame is a replica domain. The PG only resides in the one replica domain. It cannot cross replica domains. This reduces a lot of copy set. You can see the M. In the Ceph OSD tree, we use a replica domain bucket instead of a rank bucket. We also change the crash map ruler. In the ruler, we first pick up one replica domain. In the new crash map, we reduce the number of copy set. The durability 9 is 10. Compared with the defaulting crash map setting, we improve durability 100 times. In the past, I will share our operation experience. We use Puppet to deploy our Ceph cluster. Our Puppet Ceph model is different from Innovance and StackForge. Our Puppet Ceph model have many advantages, such as shorter deployment time and supporting all Ceph options and supporting multi-disk time. Our operation goal is availability. We need to reduce unnecessary data migration and reduce the slow request. when we upgrade the Ceph before you restart the Ceph OSD process, you need first Markdown OSD, it will be reduced slowly request. Before we reboot host, we also need a Markdown OSD, It also can reduce the slow request. When we expand the Ceph capacity, you need a setting crash map and trigger data migration in the middle night. When we meet disk corruption, we need to replace the disk. The most important is ensure the replica domain is unchanged. This avoids the unnecessary data migration. We use Diamond to collect performance the targets data and the Ceph class the status. The graphic store the data and the Grafana is used to display the data. Ceph's alerting is based on Jabbies. According to the Ceph architecture, we create the slotting model. The write request will pass through all the slotters. So according to the slot model, we add the new collector in the diamond and redefine the metric names in the graphic. As you see, there is a matrix in the graphic. The graphic UI is ugly. The picture shows the fine store generally kills the latency. This is a Grafana display. The first is the IOPS. The second is the bandwidth. The third is the OSD general latency. The fourth is the reader request latency. In the past year, we meet many accidents. The most dangerous accident is XFS bug. The bug will down all OSD. Thank you for your watching.
So the slides is shorter, and maybe you have many questions. I'm not sure, but anyone? Okay. Yeah. What? Oh. Yeah. Oh, no problem. Yeah. So, any other question about performance or crash map or others? Okay, close.
So from a hardware perspective, are you using traditional 1U nodes, SSDs? Are you looking at any of the exotic systems that have much higher count, you know, 30 in 1U or something? Just out of curious, what you built with?
Sorry, I kind of get clearly about your meaning.
What's the hardware look like?
Hot walk. Okay. One U and eight SSD, three SSD each server, and each link has 18 server. Each server is 1U, and each server has 3 SSD.
And how much network?
All is 10 gigabytes. 10 GB. One. Okay.